Just to recap the mistakes from my last year from my tomato cages, they were only 8 inches in diameter, which is just not big enough for those tomatoes to fully grow and to support the weight. They were 4 foot tall, which just isn't tall enough either, and they just fell over. They didn't have enough support. So this year I'm doing a couple things differently. I picked up this wire mesh fencing. It has little holes in it that are 2 inches by 4 inches, and it's 5 foot tall. So it's a whole foot taller than what I had last year. And the other thing I'm going to do differently is instead of 8 inches in diameter, I'm going to expand it to 18 inches in diameter, which I'm hoping is plenty of space to let those tomatoes grow and leaf out and provide them lots of room to grow. And the third thing I'm going to do differently is provide them some support with a piece of rebar down through the middle so that when it does get windy, when the tomatoes do get laden, when they get laden with fruit on the vines, they won't just fall over. They'll have that strong rebar for support. So what I'm going to do is unroll this and cut a 60-inch piece that will give me a tomato cage that is 18 inches in diameter. So we'll cut this apart and we'll build the cage and show you what it looks like. I have got my piece of wire mesh cut, my 60-inch piece, and also these are the little end pieces from the wire. I'm going to cut those off because those are going to be really sharp and could poke you. We're not going to use them to connect to make it round. We're not going to use those to connect. I'm going to use some cable ties. That way at the end of the season I can cut off the cable ties and I can store them flat under my deck or along a fence or something like that. It'll be a whole lot easier to store these. I've got my cable ties. I'm going to put about maybe 4 or 5 cable ties to connect these. And that way, like I said, we can cut the cable ties at the end of the season and store them flat. If you use the wire to connect it, whoops, if you use the wire to connect it, it would be a whole lot harder to get apart at the end of the season. So I thought the cable ties would work well. Except I need to take my gloves off. Can't do it with gloves on. All right. We'll get this. This thing kind of likes to get away from you. Okay, you want to connect your cable ties like diagonally. I do it in the middle first. It stays together so well. Okay, there we go. Now I have it together. You can see it'll pop apart real easily. So then I'll connect one on each end next. You know, you just do what works for you. That's what works for me, so, or it doesn't work. All right, the last step before our cages are done is on the bottom of your cage, you're gonna want some wire to stick into the ground to give it just that little bit of extra support. So we're gonna wanna cut every other wire. Okay, there we go. Tomato cage is done. Let's go see how it works in the ground. Let's go plant a tomato. Well, this is where I'm going to start planting my tomatoes. I'm going to plant actually 2 tomatoes in this section. And believe it or not, last year I think I had 4. So it was so overgrown and it was really even hard to pick the tomatoes. Okay, I'm just going to set my tomato cages right here just so I can get an idea of spacing. Okay, so that's good. It'll be about 24 inches apart. We'll do it right here. And right. Okay, ready to plant. I've got my hole dug here, and I've got my tomato plant. This is an Amish paste, which is like a Roma tomato plant that I grew from seed. I have it in these little red plastic cups. And what I'm gonna do before I plant, though, very important, is I've already amended the soil, but we're going to put a little bit of extra amendment in the hole just so that our tomato plant has the good nutrients it needs in order to grow big and strong and healthy. So what I like to do is, even though I already add a compost to my dirt here, I like to add another scoop of compost to the hole. So just throw in a handful. I've got compost here in this bucket. And also what I found works wonders for tomatoes is Epsom salt. It's the magnesium that the tomatoes really like. So I'm going to go ahead and pour a small handful, maybe, I don't know, maybe a tablespoon or so. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that in the hole also and mix it up with the compost that I already have in the hole. And then I'll give my tomato plant a nice good start. So then we'll go ahead and take my plant out of its cup. So you wanna leave the top leaves just sticking out a little bit. You wanna plant them deep so that they develop roots all around the stem. It's very important for a strong, stable tomato plant. Okay, so just have the top leaves sticking out. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this hole in with dirt. My soaker hose will eventually get covered up as well. Okay, I got my cage in, got my first tomato planted. Now we gotta add our rebar to reinforce it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to thread the rebar in through the wire mesh with the tomato cage so that it will hold it as the tomato sets fruit and gets heavy. Pound it into the ground and then we are done. All right. Okay, there. Hopefully that'll be nice and sturdy. It sure feels a lot sturdier than my cages from last year. Okay, look at this little tomato down here. It's almost funny. It's so tiny compared to this big cage. You might not think it will grow to fill this big cage, but believe me, it will. Especially this particular brand of tomato, it grows huge with big Roma tomatoes. And I cannot wait to taste those big juicy tomatoes. So, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you've learned a little bit. I sure have learned a lot in this process. And we'll have to come back and show you the progress of these tomatoes. But right now I gotta water it before it wilts in this hot sun. Make sure you leave me some comments. Let me know any ideas you might have for tomato cages if you've ever built your own before. And if you have any suggestions for how to make mine even better. So, thanks a lot for watching. Have a great day.